We don't accept that. I will give you proof. We don't want to hear the proof. This Hizbiyah is also present in the blind followers of the Madhabs, that the Hanafis and the Shafi'is and the Malikis and other than them. Same thing. Same Hizbiyah. You tell them the Prophet ﷺ prayed like this. Or this is the Aqeedah of the Sahaba. They say, no. We are upon our Madhab. You say, okay, let's take the Aqeedah of your Imam, Imam Shafi'i. Was Imam Shafi'i Ash'ari? They say, yes. I said, how is that possible? They say, he's Ash'ari. The Imam Shafi'i Ash'ari. Say, when did Imam Shafi'i die? 204. After the Hijrah. He's Ash'ari? Say, yes. Say, Abu Hassan al-Ash'ari died in 324 after the Hijrah. 120 years after Imam Shafi'i. How can a man who came 100 years after Imam Shafi'i, how can Imam Shafi'i follow him? Imam Shafi'i not Ash'ari. Imam Abu Hanifa. They don't take the Aqeedah of Abu Hanifa. They are staunch upon following them in their fiqh, but they abandon, as Shaykh al-Fawzan, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, mentions, that they leave alone the Aqeedah, they leave alone the belief of those A'imma, of those great Imams and scholars, and they hold staunchly to the fiqh that they're upon. This is Hizbiyah, because they will abandon the Hadith in the blind following of their Shaykh. This is Hizbiyah, even if that Hizbiyah is rooted, even though the Imams are free of that. Such as Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal, what did he say? لا تقلدوني ولا تقلد مالك ولا تقلد شافعي ولا مالك ولا أوزاعي ولا الثوري. He said, don't make taqleed of me. Don't have this Hizbiyah towards me, this ta'assub. This taqleed, that everything that I say, you're going to follow it. Even if it opposes the book and the sunnah. He said, don't do that with me. Don't do that with me, Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. And likewise, don't do it with Imam Shafi'i. And likewise, don't do it with Imam Malik. And likewise, not with Imam Sufyan al-Thawri, nor with Imam al-Awza'i. But rather, take from where they took. Same statements you find from Abu Hanifa. Same statements you find from Imam Malik. Same statements you find from Imam Shafi'i. إذا سأل الحديث فهو مذهبي. This is a statement of Imam Shafi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala. If the hadith is authentic, then that is my madhab. Now a person leaves the authentic hadith, and he will say, no, I'm going to blindly follow. I don't care what the hadith says. Don't bring me Bukhari. Don't bring me Muslim. Don't bring me the narrations of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I will not change. I'm going to stick to my madhab because this is what my parents taught me. This is what my grandparents taught me. This is Hizbiyah. Sheikh Bakr Abu Zayd, he mentions that the Hizbiyah of old, of the madhabs, that was poisonous. It was a disease. But this Hizbiyah of new is even worse. Which Hizbiyah of new? The Hizbiyah of the likes of these Jama'at, Ikhwan al-Muslimin, Jama'at al-Tabligh, Jama'at al-Jihad, Hamas, and others. That this Hizbiyah is even worse than the Hizbiyah of old. Because the Hizbiyah of old, at least they try to follow, or they try to connect themselves to an Imam. Who are they following, these people of today? Hassan al-Banna? Not a scholar. Sayyid Qutb? Not a scholar. A writer and a thinker and a philosopher. Not a scholar. Muhammad Ilyas, a Sufi. You can't say that about the great Imams. Imam Shafi, Abu Hanifa, Malik, Ahmed. Imams, Sunnah. Upon the Aqeedah Sahiha, by and large. They're upon the Aqeedah Sahiha. As for these lot today, which Aqeedah? Sayyid Qutb, Sufi, Mufawwid. A person of the Aqeedah of the Asha'ira. Person of Tafweed, Sufi, a person who believed that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was in every place. Hassan al-Banna likewise, used to make muraqabah at the graves, used to sit at the graves and ponder and think, and gather at the graves of the dead. So which a'imma, which imams are they following? Shaykh Rabi, he mentions, you will not find, except that they have hatred for the people of Hadith. And they cannot mention, and they cannot bear their mentioning. So he mentions that these people, you will find such as the Hizbi of our times, and nor those who sail upon their ship, that they are from the people of falsehood, the liars, falsely claiming that they are Salafi. You will not find except that they have hatred for the people of Hadith. Then they cannot tolerate their mentioning or hearing their names. So you find them. You say, I'm Salafi. You say, what do you say about Shaykh Al-Albani? Shaykh Al-Albani Murji. You said that you're a pure Salafi. And now you're saying Sheikh Al-Albani Murji. How does that make you Salafi? You say, what about Sheikh Muqbil? Sheikh Muqbil, wallahi, out in the desert, leave him where he is. That's what they say. Salafi, anta. How are you Salafi when you say that about the ulama? Sheikh bin Baz, oh Sheikh bin Baz, wallahi, I'm Salafi, but Sheikh bin Baz too close to the rulers. Salafiyya? You're not Salafi. This is not Salafiyya. How many people that you meet, you say, akhi, كيف حال alhamdulillah, everything, alhamdulillah. He goes, akhi, I'm Salafi. Say, alhamdulillah, anta Salafi. And in the course of the conversation, he says, but you know, Sheikh Al-Albani had some things with him. Say, okay, who else? He said, Sheikh bin Baz, too close to the rulers. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen, he was maybe too scared to speak. Say, who are the ulama then? He said, the ulama are in prison. Anta Salafi? Which Salafi? Which ulama are in prison? Which Salafi scholars are in prison? There are no Salafi ulama in prison. Who are you referring to? Abu Qatada? Palestini? Or Abu Hamza al-Masri? Which scholars are you referring to? They're not scholars. They are Uwaybida. Prophet ﷺ described them correctly. That they are the despicable ones. Who are they? Describe them to us. The companion said. He said they are the ones who are small. They are from the despicable, lowly ones who speak out about public affairs. They don't have the knowledge, but they speak out. Umar Bakri, Abu Qatada, Abu Hamza al-Masri, Usama bin Laden. These types of individuals. Ruwaybida. So these individuals, some of them, you'll find them using the term Salafi. Ba'az ibn Qayyim rahimahullah ta'ala mentions that the changing the name of something does not change its reality. Calling a takfiri a Salafi does not make him Salafi. Sometimes the brothers have a misunderstanding in this affair. You say, akhi, you know, you speak against so-and-so, like, you know, maybe you speak against Umar Bakri. Umar Bakri says he's Salafi. He does, actually. He says, I'm Salafi now. This Tahriri, Mubtadi, innovator, Umar Bakri Muhammad, from the heads of Al-Muhajirun, this group, of this Khilafah group, he says that he's Salafi. He says, akhi, but he says he's Salafi. I say, okay, take a bottle of whiskey, rip off the label, put on spring water. What's inside the bottle? He says, akhi, it's whiskey. He said, change the label of Umar Bakri, inside you have a takfiri. Changing his label does not change his reality. Have you ever met a Sufi who says that I'm not Sunni? Never. Every Sufi, Quburi, grave worshipper, travel all the way to Baghdad in the middle of the war to go to the grave of Abdul Qadir Jilani. He will say, I'm Sunni. Because he has to go to the grave of Abdul Qadir Jilani because he believes that Abdul Qadir Jilani, rahimahullah, that he goes to his grave and asks from him that Abdul Qadir Jilani will cure him. Or at the least, Abdul Qadir Jilani will be a wasila between him and Allah. Will be an intermediary between him and Allah. All day he will go to Baghdad. In the middle of the insurgency, dodging bullets and rockets and bombs to go to the grave of Abdul Qadir Jilani. Or those Shia that would travel all the way from Iran and Pakistan, all the way to Najaf, to the grave of Ali, radiallahu anhu. Because they say, my child is ill, I've got to take him to the grave of Ali. But those Sufis, because that's what we're talking about, ever meet a Sufi who doesn't say that he's Sunni? They will say, we are the Ahlul Sunnah wa Antum Wahhabiyun. You are the Wahhabis, we are Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Do they not say that? That's what they say. Don't be fooled by these labels. Yes, of course, if a person says that I am Ahlul Sunnah, that I am, wallahi, I love the Sunnah, I love the Sahaba, I follow their Aqeedah, I follow their methodology, I follow their creed, I follow their way, I follow the hadith of the Prophet ﷺ, I take the understanding of the early generations of scholars and imams. Wallahi, this is what I'm upon. I love Sheikh bin Baz, Sheikh Al-Albani. Of course, that label befits him. And that's why Sheikh bin Baz, rahimahullah ta'ala, when he was asked the question, that is this usage of the title, Sunni, or Salafi, or Athari, is this something good? Is this not a tazkiyah? Is this not just a person giving tazkiyah to his own nafs, praising his own self? Sheikh bin Baz said that this tazkiyah is wajibah. Sheikh bin Baz said that this commendation is obligatory. Because how do you distinguish the people of Haqq from the people of Batil? So the call, what I'm mentioning here, is not that we give up the label. We don't say, well, I'm just a Muslim. No, because the Prophet ﷺ didn't say that. Because the Prophet ﷺ described the Muslims with many different titles. He mentioned them with the term ghuraba, did he not? Bada Islamu ghariba. He said that Islam began as something strange. سيعود غريبة كما بدأ. And it will